Ta-dum.
Ta-dum. What's my best one?
From the top of my head, it's Fate.
I remember I saw this show over lockdown called The Midnight Gospel, which it's not so much magical, but it's very like whimsical and psychedelic.
Sometimes when I'm watching shows that I am recommending to friends and I watch it with them, I sometimes am too conscious about them not liking it or not liking it as much as I do.
I totally agree.
When I watch something by myself, I feel like I have a far greater appreciation of, you know, my taste.
I like to like binge shows and like watch the same one for 3 days and just finish it.
I literally just watched Lupin. And Omar Sy is...
I really want to watch it.
Oh, I'd love him. He's just got such a naturalistic, kind of unashamed way of...
Oh, you know, I absolutely loved The Queen's Gambit. I'm in love with Anya Taylor-Joy, so probably her, I'd have to say. I quite like a funny villain, so I'd have to say in Scott Pilgrim versus the World, I can't remember the name of the villain, but it's like the ultimate ex-boyfriend, and it makes me laugh so much.
I've got to go for Joker. I mean, Heath Ledger changed the game for a lot of people our age. It was the anti-hero that everyone loved more than the hero.
I loved Anne with an E. It was just so like, oh, it just takes you into another world. It's so gorgeous.
I don't know if you've seen Legion. It's kind of loosely based in the X-Men world. It's fantastic. Not many people I've spoken to have watched it, which I'm surprised because it's one of those ones that's very quirky and full of character and very well done, which is also Noah Hawley, so give it a watch. Kevin Spacey in House of Cards, he would be a very interesting addition into the mix, having that very maniacal, slightly sociopathic character.
I probably have to say Eleven from Stranger Things, just because she's already got that really cool power, and I feel like she'd really fit in with the fairies as well. Spirited Away. I don't know why.
Dragon Ball Z.
The Office. I don't know why.
Titanic. Avatar.
Howl's Moving Castle. Stranger Things.
X-Men. Dunkirk.
Okja. I think that's how you pronounce it. I love that one.
Gravity.
The Midnight Gospel. I probably have to say Peaky Blinders, because it's one of my favourites, and it's just so good. There's always a bit of drama around the corner.
The Wire or the Sopranos, they still stand up. I've rewatched them.
I love Orange is the New Black. It's just a really good one to watch with friends. I don't know why. I like Black Mirror as well. I like to be a bit freaked out sometimes. I love a good, like, visceral, realistic horror.
Ooh, I think it might even be in production. Avatar, The Last Airbender is one of the best shows ever made and still is. If you rewatch it, it is so good.
Studio Ghibli, because that is just my childhood with those shows. But also I feel like you can't get better than that animation. It was so beautiful. So I'd probably have to say one of those, but I hope they don't because they're so perfect in themselves.